Pick something meaningful and memorable to you, but not so obvious that it's easy to guess. Make each password unique by adding a variation at the beginning or end of your passphrase.
Seriously, let's talk real password strength. For so many years, we've been led to believe all sorts of things about strong passwords. Some people recommend lines from songs or quotes. Your workplace wants you to use 14 characters with a complexity requirement of uppercase, numbers, and punctuation. Your friend insists on his voodoo way of taking letters from the names of his pets mixed with their birthdays. You're just trying to sign up for some online account and end up deciding on something quick and easy. I'm telling you, every single one of these methods is wrong because they ignore the single most fundamental principle of passwords. Let's get started. First, let's talk about how password strength is actually measured. In information theory, randomness of data is called entropy, which is measured in bits. In a coin toss, there's two possible outcomes, heads and tails. You only need to guess twice to cover all of the possible results. To get the entropy of a coin toss, we just take log base 2 of the number of possibilities, giving us 1 bit. You can reverse this by raising 2 to the number of bits to get the total number of outcomes. So if I told you that the entropy of winning the lottery is 28 bits, that means you have 1 in 268 million chance of winning, or 2 to the 20th power. In modern computing, 128 bits is the minimum strength for encryption algorithms like AES. For reference, the number of atoms in the universe is estimated at 2 to the 272 power. With all that out of the way, let me show you how this applies to passwords. So password strength is just its length multiplied by the entropy per symbol used. A symbol could be a character, word, or emoji. The entropy per symbol depends on the size of the set it comes from. For example, a set of numbers 0 through 9 has 3.3 bits per symbol. I need 39 random numbers to achieve 128 bits of strength. As you increase the set sizes to have more possibilities, like ASCII or Unicode, the length requirement decreases. If you're great at memorizing 39 random numbers, then you don't need any other symbols. For most people though, memorizing a phrase of words is much easier because you can mentally associate between them. I personally use this method since it's easy to remember and fast for me to type. It was popularized by an XKCD comic many years back and referred to as Diceware, since you had to manually roll dice to select words from a dictionary of 7,000 plus words. Now, there may be times when you don't need 128 bits of strength. In that case, just simply use fewer symbols in your password. A key thing to remember is that passwords have to be randomly generated. Human psychology is actually quite predictable, so just pulling characters or phrases out of your head drastically reduces the password strength. Modern cracking techniques have turned to analyzing social media, classic literature, and Wikipedia to seed their attacks, along with your traditional mangling and padding techniques. So if you think your current password's strong, let me show you hashes.org. It's a community that collects and cracks leaked password hashes. We can go to cracking, left and found lists, and then download found passwords from any year. Then you can decompress with 7-zip to see what's been recovered. As you can see here, there's a ton of passwords that seem to be strong, but really are not that strong. To sum it all up, it doesn't really matter what you use for your password, as long as it's got enough entropy for your security appetite. This means randomly generated and sufficiently long. A shared Wi-Fi password, 80 bits works. Master key for your password manager, I'd do 128. By the way, I'd love to get into password managers today, but we'll save that for another episode. If you found this video helpful, give it a thumbs up and share it with your friends. Thanks so much for tuning in. Don't forget to subscribe for more content. And if you have any questions, please let me know. See you soon.